We don't know how to utilize it. What we have to tell the government, you change your laws to utilize the man force, to utilize the population. So your grandmother was correct that the more children you have, she will also be better. And there's a third category, sister. They aren't poor. They aren't bothered about less children. I can take care of them better. What they say, who wants to take the headache of upbringing the children? You know, I'm rich. No problem, money. I'm not bothered whether my son becomes a doctor or engineer. But who wants to take care of looking after the children? Third category. You know, there are certain communities, you know, even Gujaratis, they marry early. They have children early, and by the time they are 35 years old, 40 years old, their child is 15 years, 20 years, they are sitting on the seat of the business of their father. So by the time they reach 45, they can retire. They don't have to wait till 60 years. Marry early, have children, children take care of the business, and they relax early. So even the third category, if they want to enjoy life, it is better they marry early, they have children, they take care of the business, they'll enjoy life better. So that's the reason, as far as planning is concerned, Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 54, Makru makrallahu wallahu khairul makirin. They planned and plotted. Allah too planned. Allah is the best of planners. So if you feel Almighty God can plan your family better, leave it to Almighty God. If you can think you can do better, the choice is yours. I believe in Almighty God. I let Him plan my family. And that's the reason I'm here. Now coming to your second question. In Islam, men marry 4 times, 5 times, and they don't ask permission from the first 5. Why? As far as polygyny is concerned, a man having more than one wife, Islam is the only religion, and Quran is the only religious scripture on the face of the earth which says marry only one. There is no religious scripture besides the Quran. I'm a student of comparative religion, which says marry only one. There's no verse in the Bible, no verse in the Bhagavad Gita, no verse in the Veda which says marry only one, except the Quran. If you read the Hindu scriptures in Ramayana, the father of Sri Ram, how many wives did he have? How many wives?
More than one.
More than one. 3 wives. Fine. Sri Krishna, according to Mahabharata, how many wives he had?
Unlimited.
Not unlimited. You don't know your scripture well.
No.
Did he have 4 wives?
No. I have no idea.
Not 4, not 100, not 1,000, 16,108 wives. How many wives he had? 16,108. So why can't we Muslims have 4? What's the problem? When Sri Krishna can have 16,108 wives, why can't we have 4? Further, if you read the Vishnu Purana, chapter number 24, verse number 1, it says a Brahmin can have up to 4 wives. If you read the Jewish scriptures, it gives you permission to have as many wives as you wish. If you read the Christian Bible, it gives you permission to have as many wives as you wish. If you read the Bible, Abraham had 3 wives. Solomon, how many wives he had? He had 700 wives. It is later on, the church has put a ban that Christians should marry only one, not the Bible. It is the Jewish community married more than one wife. It was in 1950 that Chief Rabbi passed a synod that Jews should marry only one. So it is the Rabbi, not the Jewish scriptures. And according to Hindu scriptures, you can marry as many as you wish. It is the Indian government in 1954 passed a law called the Hindu Special Marriage Act. Hindu Special Marriage Act, which says Hindu should marry only one. It is not the religious scripture. It is not Bhagavad Gita. It is not Ramayana. It is not Mahabharata. It is not Veda. It is the Indian Penal Code. The Indian government, which has passed a law in 1954 that Hindus should marry only one. But according to the statistics of the status of the woman in Islam, if you read the government documents on page number 6667, it says that Muslims do polygamous marriages. You know what is the percentage in India? 4.3%. How much? In India, 4.3% of the Muslim men do polygamous marriages. The statistic between 1951 to 1961, Hindus, how many? 5.06, 0.7% more than the Muslims in India. According to the Indian government, even though it is prohibited according to the Indian law, yet they do more polygamous marriages than the Muslims. Why? Now, let's analyze what does the Quran say. Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse number 3, marry woman of your choice in twos, threes or fours. But if you can't do justice, marry only one. This statement, marry only one, is only given in the Quran and no other scripture. It says, marry woman of your choice in twos, threes or fours. But if you can't do justice, marry only one. So if you want to marry more than one woman, one of the criteria of the Quran is you should do justice. If you can't do justice, you should marry only one. Now, what are the reasons, logical reasons a person can think that why has Islam permitted certain men to have more than one wife? Many non-Muslims think it is fard, it is compulsory for a Muslim man to have more than one woman, to have more than one wife. It's not compulsory, it's optional. It's not fard, it's not compulsory. How many Muslim men do you know who have more than one wife? How many do you know, sister? How many do you know?
A few.
How many?
A few, again.
Few means one, two, three, how many?
Yeah, at least about three.
About three. Have you heard of Dharminder?
Yeah.
How many wives he has?
Two.
Muslim or non-Muslim?
Non-Muslim.
Non-Muslim. Your previous chief minister, what's the name?
Jayalalitha.
Yes. Hindu or Muslim? Hindu or Muslim?
Hindu.
Hindu, fine. Now, these are famous personalities. Fine. How many famous personalities you know in India who have got more than one wife? The three you know may be locality, fine?
Yeah.
Local, maybe friend in a neighborhood, maybe your colleague. In India, there are more non-Muslims having more than one wife than the Muslims. Now, let us understand what are the logical reasons. Come back to logic now. Now, by nature, if you ask any medical doctor, he will tell you, male and female are born in equal proportion. Girls and boys are born in equal proportion. But any medical doctor, any pediatrician, any children doctor will tell you that the female sex, the female child is stronger than the male child. That's the reason there are more deaths in the male children as compared to female children. So in children's age itself, the female children are much more than the male children. As life grows on, there are people dying due to accidents, due to alcoholism, due to war. There are more males dying as compared to females. Today, if you analyze in the world, there are more females in the world as compared to males. There are few third world countries like India where the male population is more than the female population. And do you know why? The reason is because of female feticide and female infanticide. According to an article, a program which came on BBC by the name Let Her Die, the program was assignment, there was a British reporter by the name of Emily Beckenin. She comes to India and she says that every year in India, more than 1 million fetuses are being aborted after they identified that they're females. She says more than 3,000 every day. You multiply, more than 1 million every year. According to the Tamil Nadu government hospital report, she gives the statistics, out of 10 female born alive, do you know how many are put to death? Four. Sister, did you know that? Tamil Nadu, your state, your beloved state, according to the government statistics, out of 10 females born alive in the government hospital, four are put to death. There are billboards put in Rajasthan and here, which says that spend 500 rupees and save 500,000 rupees. You know what does it indicate? Spend 500 rupees, do ultrasonography, do amniocentesis, identify the child you're carrying is a female, abort her, and save 5 lakh rupees, 500,000 rupees. Maybe a couple of 100,000 upbringing her and the remaining 100,000 in dowry.